Whenever I say communication or the word sales speech, you said there was a smile on Rohan's face. So why don't we ask Rohan only? Rohan, how important is communication for a startup to raise funds?
So you know, Prank, actually, I have a just a different. You had asked this that support part, right? I believe that investors are like, you know, this is where a lot of founders actually get it wrong. They start thinking as an investor's answer of yes or no as validation to their idea, right? Which I would definitely suggest people never to do that, right? Because you're going to hear at least 50 to 100 no's before you hear that one yes, right? And that one yes is, of course, someone who's believing in you as a person, right? Rather than, again, looking at you based on your statistics. So, you know, in terms of where people sometimes get it wrong is that they start losing faith in themselves, and that's where the downhill slope starts coming in. Whereas I believe that, you know, you can, I don't believe that there is a failure of a business, right? I believe that there's a failure of a business model, right? But I also believe that there are ways to sort of pivot that and adjust according to times, right? Like we've all seen COVID has come over here. It's affected the world, but because a lot of businesses have shut down, yes, you know, I mean, my condolences to all of them, but I also feel like had you sort of evolved yourself accordingly, right, that would have helped a lot. Because so what if you're doing a certain thing right now, right? That doesn't mean you can't do another sort of segue into doing something else, right? I mean, yes, it should be related. Yes, and you're doing something with travel and then you go on to do something with, you know, something completely absurd. To answer your question, the communication part, right? It's very, very important, right? Because the team that you're building from the start, you don't look at these people as employees. These are all people of that you're building that are part of your core team, right? I call them my family, to be very honest with you, right? Because if they don't believe in your vision and in your idea, they're not going to be motivated to work. They're not going to be motivated to build that big vision that you have. They go, paisa to aa jayega. Money will flow if you're solving a real problem, right? But if you don't have the support Absolutely. Of the correct people, of the correct team, it's going to be very difficult for you. So communication with your team, I would say that is number one. Because if your team believes in you, you know, I agree with Vedant when he says that investing definitely gives you that kind of rapid growth to market, the kind of scale. You do need that, right? Because nowadays, the rate at which competition is coming, you may need external funding at some point to beat that competition, right? But it's not the existence of your business, right? So first, communication would be, in my opinion, the team, right? Motivating them, making them actually believe that the problem that you're solving is real, right? Because that is when their passion comes in. Second is the kind of communication that you have with, you know, the people, your support system, be it your family, be it your, you know, your CAs, your lawyers, any one of those sorts. Because again, you know, if you don't like these three CAs, doctors and lawyers, right? These three are the people that you should never lie to, because these three are the people who can always, you know, sort of make sure that you know what are the sort of consequences. So I would say be very truthful. Be very transparent, even when it comes to investors, even when it comes to your team. Be as transparent, as honest as possible, because I've seen that even though my years of experience are, you know, very little compared to the people who I'm speaking with at right now, but trust and transparency goes a very long way, right? When you're working with that, with a pure belief of what you're solving is real, and, you know, that comes out in the kind of conviction of what you're talking about, I think that makes a very big difference. So communication, being honest, being sort of transparent, being reliable, I would say that these are very, very, very important regardless of who it is you speak to. Yes, the pitch changes a little bit when it's a team, lawyer and an investor, but your underlying motive should be that, in my fair opinion.
Excellent piece of advice again, Rohan. You focused a lot on the value system, a lot about integrity, honesty, and of course, having the belief and considering your team as your family, which is the most important thing. I mean, if things are going south, your family members will stick to that and they will help you go north. I mean, there's no question about it. And if the tech team, let's say, if your founding team becomes that family to you, then no wonders you will touch wood, never see the downhill. And thank you so much for bringing this secret piece of advice again with so much passion and enthusiasm, Rohan. All right, next.